is this we're doing?
You said we're doing a spring cleaning video.
Well, spring has finally arrived, and with it comes the opportunity to get out into the garden and enjoy that sunny, splendid show of new colour, of new growth,
of new sounds, new smells. No, not that one. This one.
And with all this new activity comes new jobs to be done in the garden. And this video will show you how to tick off some of those tasks from your to-do list. We'll show you how to take your paving from green to clean, take on the edges and hedges, and tackle the tops as we embark on the big green spring clean. How have we got up here? Mate, we're gonna have to really stop with these walkie-talkie intros. You're gonna have to do one of those edits. You know when you click your fingers and you end up teleporting?
Yeah, that should work.
Whoa. Well done. You best edit me out of here at some point. But to be honest, whilst I'm up here, this actually brings us into quite a nice serious point, because this is an opportune time to tackle some of that loftier lopping and chopping. This is a great time to tackle storm and winter damage in the canopy. With a new leaf yet to appear, you can easily identify broken or damaged branches, as well as areas affected by disease or insects. But how do you cut down branches when they're up here? It's time to start lopping and chopping. You can also ensure you won't disturb any nesting birds, because you're looking straight up into a bare canopy. It's a great opportunity to get rid of those branches that perhaps took out that precious sunlight last year. And by doing it now, it means you don't have to contend with all that extra fleshier foliage. Well, that's the tops taken care of, but now it's down to ground level. And winter can be wicked on your patio, your paving, your decking, any outdoor surface. It bombards it all winter long with pretty much anything it can throw at it. So let's have a look at what we're up against. Firstly, you've got rainwater. And first glance, you'd think rainwater is clean, but no, there's plenty of mineral deposits, and that's what allows all the algae to start blooming on your driveway, on your patio, and on your paving. Then we've got our leaf fall. Winter winds, storms, breaking free branches, foliage, twigs, all landing and blighting our outdoor surfaces, getting into those drains and gutters and playing havoc. And if we go out to play in that winter weather in the garden, we too leave a calling card behind us, because if we're playing around in that soggy soil, we soon start throwing down our own dirty deposits too. So between the wet, the windy, and the dirty, winter pretty much throws everything at our outdoor surfaces. So how do we wash away all these wicked winter woes? So whether it's soil on your stonework, dirt on your deck, or if your garage is looking grotty, all outdoor surfaces will benefit from some routine cleaning. And personally, I don't think you can beat using a pressure washer. There's something thoroughly enjoyable about rejuvenating and restoring your outdoor surfaces. Well, we tackled the tops, we've pampered the patio, but if your garden's still looking a little bit rough around the hedges, it's time to get tooled up. And I mean, proper tooled up.
Now, without beating around the bush, you can't go lopping and topping with anything less than the best. So when I say proper tooled up, I'm not talking about your grandmother's hand shears. Those things aren't going to cut the mustard, let alone your highest hedgerows. If we want to cream these crops, we're going to need power, reach, portability, versatility. Enter Tommy the Tool. So cool, because he's got all the gear and no idea.
Whoa, 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 what do you mean, no idea? To be honest, it doesn't matter whether you're clueless when it comes to cutting hedges. It's all about having the right tool for the job. And this is one of them. Pole hedge trimmer means I can get right up high, especially things like your coniferous hedges, which are starting to put that spring surge and new growth on. Before you know it, your garden is closing in at the sides. There's one thing to be mindful of at this time of year, because this could be somebody's home. And the last thing we want to be doing is rustling any feathers. So always worth making sure that you haven't got any birds nesting in here, and only take off that new flouncier, softer growth By coniferous hedges, I mean things like thuja or thuja, which is a lovely lemony scent when you cut it. Capressus lalandii, which grows at a rate of knots and is worth getting on top of as soon as possible. And things like macrocarpa or yew. Now, you can always give your bush a good trim too at this time of year, especially things like box hedging, Buxus sempervirens. It's a bit of an early bloom, especially if it's in a happy position, and it's worth tackling your topiary too. And the advantage of a battery-powered hedge trimmer is that there's no fuel, no fumes, no cords, no cables. All you need to do is charge, click, and cut. Well, I hope the weather's good where you are and that you get out and embrace your outdoor space this week. And if you're looking for the right gear to get your garden clean and clear, then you can always check the link at the end of the video. And hang around, because our next instalment of Embrace Your Outdoor Space will be helping you to fix a fence, liven up your lawn, and grow your own greens. Go on then, now you can do it. Go on. Yeah! 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 Yeah!